The Sealed Portion, The Final Testament of Jesus Christ. Chapter 1, The Header. Moroni writes the things revealed to the brother of Jared. He testifies that Jesus Christ came to the Nephites. He exhorts all to have faith and obey the commandments of God. 1. And now I, Moroni, proceed to write the great and marvelous things that the Lord hath made manifest unto the brother of Jared. 2. And I write these things according to the commandment of the Lord, in the which he hath commanded me, saying, A commandment I have given unto thee, that thou shalt write the things which I have shown unto the brother of Jared at the time he presented himself before me, and manifested great faith in my name, even so much that I could not withhold my spirit from before him. 3. And again, a commandment I give unto thee, that thou shalt include these things with the record of my people, who are the children of Lehi, who came out of Jerusalem, whose seed is a remnant of the house of Israel. 4. Behold, I have prepared these two stones as interpreters, inasmuch as I have caused the language of the Jaredites to be confounded. This I have done to hide these things from the eyes of the world. For behold, there are none, save a few only, who have faith enough to behold the things that the brother of Jared saw. 5. And I have shown unto him all the inhabitants of the world which have been, and all those which shall live upon the earth on which thou standest. Behold, I could not withhold them from his sight, even unto the ends of the earth. 6. For behold, I have covenanted with the children of men from the beginning, that if it so be that they exercise faith in me, and keep my commandments in all things, believing that I can show unto them the mysteries of godliness, behold, I will come unto them by the power of the Holy Ghost, and he shall teach them whatsoever their hearts desire, if it so be that they ask in righteousness. 7. Nevertheless, thou shalt seal up the words of the brother of Jared, until I have manifested myself in the flesh unto my people. 8. And now, I, Moroni, have written the things which the Lord hath commanded me upon the plates which I have formed with my own hands, according to the pattern shown unto me by my father. And upon these plates of my father hath an account of the resurrection of Jesus Christ been given. 9. Behold, it hath truly been manifested herein that Jesus did come unto his people. Not only did he visit the Jews who were his people at Jerusalem, but he did also manifest himself unto my fathers, according to the promises which he hath made unto them. For my fathers were separated from the Jews at Jerusalem, through the mercy and for the purposes of the Lord. 10. Therefore, I, Moroni, write the words of the brother of Jared, according to the commandment which the Lord hath given me. Nevertheless, these things shall be sealed up, and shall not be given to the children of men, with the first part of the record which my father Mormon hath made upon these plates of ore. 11. And the Lord hath made it known unto me, that these things shall be withheld from the children of men, until the day that they begin to exercise faith in God, and also in his Son, Jesus Christ, even as the brother of Jared did, that they also may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit, having overcome the sins and temptations of the world. 12. And inasmuch as they shall do these things, the Lord shall make manifest unto them all the things which the brother of Jared beheld, and all of the revelations of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, yea, even all things which have been given unto the children of men from the foundation of the world shall be revealed unto them. 13. And when the children of men begin to exercise this faith of which I have spoken, then shall the Lord reveal these things unto them. 14. And it shall come to pass that when these things shall be revealed unto them, there shall be none, save a few only, who shall understand them and receive them into their hearts. And the Spirit shall witness the truthfulness of these things unto them. 15. And many shall mock at these things, and contend against the word of the Lord. Behold, thus saith the Lord unto those who shall mock and deny these things, let them be accursed from henceforth and forever, for they have sealed unto themselves eternal damnation, insomuch that I will show no greater things unto them. 16. But those unto whom I shall reveal these things shall be laid under a strict command that they shall only reveal unto the children of men the words which I shall give unto them. For this reason have I caused these things to be written and preserved until the appointed time when all things shall be revealed for the salvation of mine elect. 17. And it shall come to pass that those who shall receive the words of the brother of Jared and accept them with gladness and harden not their hearts, to them shall be given the greater portion of my word, which is my gospel of truth, until they know the mysteries of God in full. 18. And they shall receive a new name which shall only be known and understood by those who receive it. And they shall become my friends, and I will be their God. 19. Now I, Moroni, do plead with my brethren and also my sisters, yea, even with all those who shall receive these things who are of the house of Israel, and also those among the Gentiles who shall receive these things. Yea, I say unto you, come unto the Lord, even Jesus Christ, and he will show unto you the great and marvelous things of God, which he hath caused to be hidden from the eyes of the world because of wickedness and unbelief. 20. Behold, I say unto you, that when ye shall begin to rend that veil of unbelief, which causes the Spirit of the Lord to withdraw from you, yea, when ye shall cast off the chains of the devil with which he hath you bound, then, my beloved brothers and sisters, shall these great and marvelous things which have been hid from the foundations of the world be made known unto you. 21. O, my beloved brethren, how long will the Lord our God allow the earth to lie under such bondage of sin? How long can he remain merciful unto you in your wickedness? 22. My soul is harrowed up in sorrow because of the things which the brother of Jared hath written concerning you. Behold, it is because of your wickedness that the Lord hath withheld these things from you. And behold, these same things shall condemn you at the last day. 23. And it shall come to pass in that day that the book shall be opened, and ye shall read of your corruptions and deceptions, and ye shall weep and wail and gnash your teeth as ye behold the wickedness of your ways and the deceptions of your hearts. 24. Even as the Lord requested of the Father, even so I would that this bitter cup be allowed to pass from before my lips, that I might not drink thereof and sorrow because of your sins. Nevertheless, the Lord hath commanded me, and I must obey. 25. For behold, the words of the brother of Jared are great and marvelous, and if ye mock them, ye mock God. For they are the words of Christ given unto all those who do his will and call upon his holy name, with a broken heart and a contrite spirit. End of chapter 1.